हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 2 इन साइंस, दैट इज एसिड्स, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स. इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस. सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू दिस टॉपिक टुडे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ डू एसिड्स एंड बेसिस रिएक्ट विथ मेटल्स. सो टू डिस्कस दिस लेट अस हैव एन एक्टिविटी. सेट द एपरेटस एज शोन इन द फिगर. Now take about 5 ml of dilute sulfuric acid in a test tube and add few pieces of zinc granules to it. Now observe the surface of zinc granules. Now pass the gas being evolved through the soap solution. Soap solution is taken in the container near the apparatus. Now why bubbles are formed? Check it properly. Now take a burning candle near a gas filled with bubbles and observe it properly. Now repeat this activity with some more acids like HCl, HNO3 and acetic acid and observe properly. Now 5 ml of dilute sulfuric acid plus zinc granules. What will happen? On the surface of zinc granules, bubbles of hydrogen gas are formed. Now on passing the hydrogen gas evolved through a soap solution, bubbles are formed due to low surface tension of soap solution. And on taking a burning candle near a gas filled with bubbles, what will happen? Gas burns with a pop sound. So all other acids like HCl, HNO3 or acetic acid shows the same observation as like sulfuric acid. So this is the reaction of acid with metal. It gives salt plus hydrogen gas. Now let us discuss another activity, that is activity 2.4, to show the relationship between bases and metals. So place a few pieces of granulated zinc metal in a test tube and add 2 ml of sodium hydroxide solution. This time it is the base, and warm the contents of the test tube. Now repeat the rest of the steps as in activity 2.3 and record the observations. Now here the reaction that takes place can be written as follows. Here twice NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide solution, plus zinc granules in solid form will give sodium zincate with the release of hydrogen gas. So this is the reaction of metal with bases. But remember, such reactions are not possible with all metals. Next, how do metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates react with acids? So let us have an activity to discuss this. Take 2 test tubes, label them A and B. Take about 0.5 gram of sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, in test tube A, and about 0.5 gram of sodium hydrogen carbonate, NaHCO3, in test tube B. Add about 2 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid, HCl, to both the test tubes. Now observe properly. Pass the gas produced in each case through lime water. Lime water, that is calcium hydroxide solution. Observe the diagram carefully here and record your observations. Now what will happen, we will discuss with the help of reactions that takes place. In test tube A, Na2CO3, that is sodium carbonate in solid form, plus hydrochloric acid in solution form, aqueous form, gives salt, that is NaCl, plus water plus carbon dioxide with the release of carbon dioxide gas. In test tube B, NaHCO3, sodium hydrogen carbonate, plus few drops of hydrochloric acid gives salt, again NaCl, plus water plus release of carbon dioxide gas. So on passing the carbon dioxide gas through lime water turns milky because insoluble white PPTs of calcium carbonate is formed as shown in the figure we have discussed in activity 2.5. So calcium hydroxide plus carbon dioxide means lime water in aqueous form plus carbon dioxide gas gives calcium carbonate, that is white PPTs in solid form, plus water. But On passing excessive gas through the lime water, it becomes colorless, like calcium carbonate in solid form plus water plus carbon dioxide gas gives calcium hydrogen carbonate, which is colorless. So we can say that limestone, chalk and marble are different forms of calcium carbonate. All metal carbonates and hydrogen carbonates react with acids to give a corresponding salt. Carbon dioxide and water. The reaction can be summarized as metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate plus acid gives salt plus carbon dioxide plus water. Next, how do acids and bases react with each other? To understand this, let us have an activity 2.6. Take about 2 ml of dilute sodium hydroxide solution, NaOH solution, in a test tube and add 2 drops of phenolphthalein solution to it. What will be the color of the solution? It will be pink. Now, add dilute HCl solution, hydrochloric acid solution, to the above solution drop by drop. Is there any color change for the reaction mixture? Yes. Actually, on adding dilute hydrochloric acid HCl to the above solution, the reaction mixture changes to colorless. Why it is colorless? Because phenolphthalein color changes from pink to colorless as neutralization of HCl and NaOH takes place. So now add few drops of NaOH, sodium hydroxide, to the above solution, to the above mixture. So on adding few drops of NaOH to the above mixture, pink color reappears, because initially the effect of base was nullified by an acid and so the color changed to colorless. But on addition of some more base, the pink color of phenolphthalein reappeared. So in the above activity, we have observed that the effect of base is nullified by an acid and vice versa. And reaction is as follows, that is NaOH plus HCl gives NaCl plus water. That means the reaction between an acid and base to give a salt and water is known as neutralization reaction. We have discussed already in small classes. Base plus acid gives salt plus water. Now, reaction of metallic oxides with acids. So, to discuss this, let us have an activity. Activity 2.7. Take a small amount of copper oxide in a beaker and add dilute hydrochloric acid slowly while stirring. Now, what will happen? When dilute hydrochloric acid is added to copper oxide solution, the color of the solution becomes blue-green and the copper oxide dissolves. So, the blue-green color is due to the formation of copper chloride actually. And the reaction will be CuO, that is copper oxide, plus twice HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, gives CuCl2, that is copper chloride plus water. This copper chloride gives blue-green color. This is the final reaction. Therefore, metal oxide plus any acid gives salt plus water. This CuCl2 is the salt plus release of water. Now, the reaction of non-metallic oxide with base. This is the same process with the metallic oxide plus acid. Here, the reaction we have already discussed between carbon dioxide and calcium hydroxide, that is lime water, in our last activity 2.5. Here, calcium hydroxide, which is a base, reacts with carbon dioxide to produce a salt and water, since this is similar to the reaction between a base and an acid. So we can conclude that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. So students, I hope you understood the topic of chemical properties of acids and bases and their reaction with metals, non-metals and with each other. In next video, we will discuss about what do all acids and all bases have in common. Thank you for listening.